Meatloaf is the ultimate comfort food, and when it's good, it's really good. But if your own meatloaf leaves a little something to be desired, it might be because you're making a few common mistakes. Listen and learn.
Is that crumbly meatloaf a pain to serve? Do you hate all the oil, grease, and fat it cooks in? There's gotta be a better way.
As any chef worth their salt will tell you, it's very important to let whole muscle meats like steaks, roasts, and pork loins rest after you remove them from a heat source. Well, guess what? The same rule holds for meatloaf too. You should always make sure to give your meatloaf a bit of a rest before cutting and serving. This will result in a much juicier meatloaf, one that won't fall apart the minute you slice into it. Cooks Illustrated does a really great job explaining the science here. The juices in raw meat are contained in structures within the muscle called myofibrils. When meat is cooked, these proteins contract and some of the liquid is squeezed out. By allowing the meat to rest and get away from the heat for a few minutes, you give the proteins a chance to reabsorb some of those wonderful, tasty juices. On the other hand, cutting into meat or meatloaf too quickly can ultimately result in a runoff on those liquids, making your meatloaf drier. Of course, this all leads to a burning question. Is it better to bake your meatloaf in a loaf pan or freeform on a baking sheet? There are advantages to each method, but it really comes down to a matter of taste. A freeform meatloaf exposes more surface area to the direct heat from the oven, creating more of that crunchy, nicely brown crust that many people love. On the other hand, meatloaf made in a loaf pan curls more of the juices and fat, resulting in a moister texture. You're probably asking yourself, if I use a loaf pan, is it better to let the meatloaf rest in the pan after cooking, or should I remove it? A website called Cooking the Amazing suggests beginning the cooking process by lining your pan with a sling of aluminum foil. You should then allow your meatloaf to rest in the lined pan for 15 minutes after baking. Then lift the meatloaf out of the pan by grabbing the foil sling, and be sure to tilt it in order to drain off the excess fat. Alternatively, Cook's Info suggests removing the meatloaf from the pan right after taking it out of the oven. Then you should immediately move it to a cooling rack and allow it to rest there. This will rid your meatloaf of excess fat while still allowing the juices to be reabsorbed. Of course, some people are really skeptical about resting when it comes to their meats. After all, people like their hot foods hot, and some equate resting with cooling. It's true that if too much heat escapes, your meatloaf will cool to an unappetizing temperature. But it's important to note that the temperature of cooked meats actually continues to rise after they are removed from their heat source. According to ThermoWorks, the temperature of meat rises 3 to 4 degrees during the resting phase. If you want to preserve as much heat as possible, keep your meatloaf in or on its pan during the resting phase. Similarly, don't plate your meatloaf on its serving dish until it's fully rested. This prevents the heat from transferring from the meat to the dish. Finally, tent some aluminum foil over your meatloaf to conserve some of the heat while still allowing for air circulation. Securing your foil tightly over the meatloaf will steam and soften its nice, crispy surface. The Spruce Eats offers additional tips for juicy meatloaf. First, bake with low heat, about 325 Fahrenheit. Second, use a meat thermometer and remove your meatloaf from the oven when it reaches 155 Fahrenheit to 160 Fahrenheit. Remember, the temperature will continue to rise while the meatloaf is resting, so this is the perfect time to put on the brakes. By taking these little morsels of advice to heart, you're sure to whip up the perfect meatloaf in next to no time.
Place it on this tray and pop it in the oven. When done, simply lift the handles and presto! Out comes the entire meatloaf all at once.
Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more MASH videos about your favorite foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.